Hey everybody, it's Matt Fraser and I am live. Thank you guys for joining me. I am here with my mom.
Hi everybody, I'm Angela, Matt's mom.
You know her from the TV show Meet the Frasers, and also Alexa, who is now my fiance.
Get the ring.
After last night's proposal on Meet the Frasers. And we are here with you guys live at the Simon & Schuster World Headquarters. That's why I'm all dressed up for you guys today. But more importantly, I'm here to sign your books. And I'm so excited because my brand new book, here it is. Look at this. It's called When Heaven Calls, Life Lessons from...
America's top psychic medium, Matt Fraser.
We're here to take your questions and, more importantly, to get your copy signed. So I'm going to sign every single copy that I possibly can. So make sure that you get your copy right now. You can click the link right up top, or you can go to premiercollectibles.com/whenheavencalls to get your book. I'm sorry, Heaven Calls. Can we get that link up there?
Yeah, it's there.
It's there? Yeah, explain that link. I can't say it today for some reason.
You can go to premiercollectibles.com/heavencalls to get your book.
Yes, or you can just click the link up top because I don't know how to spell premiere.
Yeah,
I'm a published author.
They can just click. That's the beauty of technology.
Thank God I have really great editors. So, this is my book, When Heaven Calls. And I just want to tell you a little bit about how it began because my mom actually has the gift of psychic ability, who you all know. And it actually started with my grandmother who had this gift, who passed it on to my mom and then in turn passed it on to me. Yes. And what's so crazy and the reason why I wanted to write this book is that even though I'm a psychic medium and my mom is a psychic medium, my grandmother, when she was alive, was a psychic medium, we all have different gifts. So I don't read the same way that my mom reads, and grandma didn't read the same way that you did. And even though we're all the same family.
But we all get the same messages.
Because we all talk to the same people.
Right.
So if we were talking to your dad or your mom that had passed on, I'll communicate with him in a different way that my mom would communicate with him and my grandmother.
Right. I would communicate by looking at tea leaves. And I also smell the spirit, and I also see, like, shadows. But mostly tea leaves.
And how did Grandma Mary read?
My mother, Mary Rose, she read cards. And she did not read tarot. She made her own set of playing cards. She just got a card, and she made pictures on them. You know, all different things. Birds, the sun, the moon, the sky, a knife, this, that. And she would pull the cards, and she would read about the person.
Because what I want to explain to you guys is that what's so amazing and what I love is that it doesn't matter how you receive your messages. You know, we all have a way to connect with our loved ones, whether you feel things, whether you sense things, whether you dream of your loved ones, whether you read cards, whether you read tea leaves, whether it is that you just meditate and get your answers, there's a way for your loved ones to reach you. And all you have to do is pay attention to those signs and pay attention to your own psychic muscle and strengthen it. And then you too can start receiving messages. And one of the things that I have to explain to you is that I can't teach everybody to see and hear dead people like I do. But what I can teach you how to do is recognize the ways that your loved ones are using to speak to you and how they get in touch with you. So I wanted to do something really special with this book. So I have my whole family in it. I have my mom in it and what it was like for me because I was a psychic kid growing up. You know, I literally grew up hearing and seeing the departed.
Yes.
And I gotta tell you guys that in the beginning, you know, it was hard for me.
You were very scared. You were, he was always seeing the departed. From 3 years old, he was seeing them. And he'd be crying and screaming, "Mom, Mom, come in the room." But first they started off with calling your name.
True. One of the first signs. So if you have a psychic child at home, and they're starting to see or hear the departed, here's some of the signs. So,
and it would always come in a voice that you're familiar with. So even though your mom is living or your dad is living, they will sound like your mother. Because Matthew would say, "What, Ma? Ma, what? What?" And I would say, "Matthew, I'm not calling you." And then you would come running in the room all afraid and you would want to not leave my side.
And I think that was the hardest thing for me when I was a kid, was really sensing and feeling things that no one else could. You know, when the spirits would call my name or say things to me, even though my mom was psychic, you couldn't hear them.
No, I never heard when they were speaking to you. No, I only hear when they speak to me.
And it can be difficult, I'm sure, as a parent. I mean, I know it was difficult for me as a child when I was telling you, Mom, I'm hearing this, or Mom, can you hear them? And I would be hearing them yelling in my ear, but you couldn't hear them.
Right. But what I would do is, you remember what I would do, I would come in the room, and Matthew would only be 3 years old, and I would say to Matthew, as he's scared, you know, hiding underneath the bed, I would say, Matthew, where's the ghost? And he would point, and I would go stand where the ghost was. And then I would say, Matthew, is Mommy standing next to the ghost? And he'd go, yes. And I would say, is the ghost hurting Mommy? And he would go, no. I go, because the dead can't hurt you. It's the living. Then I would ask him a series of questions.
Which, that didn't help me when I was a kid, by the way. That wasn't helping. So don't say that to your child at home, because it doesn't help. But she did ask me questions about it. And here's what I want you to know. If you guys are tuning in right now and you're watching, how many of you have a psychic child at home or have a child that has been having some psychic experiences? Leave it in the comments because I want to read them. I want to know who in your family has had that ability and, you know, what you've experienced with psychic kids and if they've been going through some of the things that me and my mom have talked
and
about.
And the most important thing is that they would always be afraid. No child at 4 or 5 welcomes the spirits. They are terrified. They are terrified of seeing a ghost in the room. And no, ghosts don't, they do not throw books around the room like in the movies. They do not come up and scare you in any way. They just try and talk to you. That's what they do.
Yes.
It's not like in the movies.
It's not like in the movies. It's very different. And that's why I wanted to write this book. I really wanted to share with you my experiences as a child and also ways that you can help your own child if they're going through psychic experiences.
Another way that they would experience it is smell.
Yes.
They may be sitting there and all of a sudden they'll go, Mommy, I smell coffee, or Mommy, I smell flowers, or I smell a certain cologne. Because when the spirits come around, they do have a scent, and they have the scent what meant something to them.
Exactly. Whether it be a cologne, like you said, whether it be,
yeah,
you know.
Yeah, and they'd be very strong.
Mm-hmm. So I wanted to write this book to talk about my early years and what I went through, because, you know, my gift was never accepted, and neither was my mom's and my grandmother. I mean, you're going to know that my mom never did it professionally.
Right.
Did you ever tell anybody that you were a psychic?
A few friends in high school and
like
my
how
family.
Many?
Oh, two. And otherwise, they thought you were loony.
Right. We lived in a different world. And Grandma Mary did. I mean, her own husband, my grandfather, didn't know that she was a medium. Mm-hmm. So it's amazing right now. And I feel very blessed to be with all of you here today because, you know, I know that my grandmother would have never imagined in her wildest dreams
that this would happen.
That we'd be here at Simon & Schuster and that I'd have a published book out talking about my abilities, what it was like for her growing up psychic, what it was like for you to grow up psychic, you know, and to talk about these experiences and to share them with all of you. So this is my new book. If you haven't got your copy yet, make sure that you head on over to the link up top to click and order your copy, because that's where you can submit a question. We're getting into questions. Hold on 1 second.
Sorry.
We're gonna get into questions in just a minute because we're time here. No, that's okay. And then also, Alexa, do you wanna give that link to where they can get their book?
Yes, so if you want a copy of When Heaven Calls, you can go to premiercollectibles.com/heavencalls.
Or you can click the link up top, and everybody who clicks this link is going to get a signed copy. We're gonna be signing them live on the screen for you. And also you get to submit a questions, and they're already coming in right now. Who already submitted their questions?
We have a ton.
Read some of the names. I want to hear some of the names.
We have Deborah from Bridgewater, Massachusetts. Oh, Becky from Harwich, Massachusetts. Lisa from Highland Falls, New York. We're in New York right now. Jacqueline from Hingham, Massachusetts.
Well, what's up with all these Massachusetts? Where are my West Coast people? We only have Massachusetts and New York.
Oh, we have Rhode Island.
Oh, Rhode Island.
Smithfield, Rhode Island.
What other states?
Oh, we're going to the West Coast. Francis from San Gabriel, California.
Hi, Francis.
We have Illinois, Donna from Belleville, Illinois.
Where are the rest? Why do we only have Rhode Island, Massachusetts? I want to make sure get your other states up here. Come on here.
Yeah, we have a couple New Hampshire. Betty from West Palm Beach, Florida.
Oh, nice. We also live in West Palm Beach.
Yes, so we have a bunch of questions for you to answer.
So before we get started, I just want to tell you a little bit about my book and what it's about, because I know that I've been teasing you guys with it, but I want to go through some of the chapters to let you know. So in the very beginning, what I really wanted this book to do was start with my early years of growing up psychic and then really fast forward at the end of the book to talk about the TV show and how it came to be. Because many of you guys don't know, but my true life story is that I never wanted to be a psychic medium. I actually started my career as an EMT. I wanted to help people, you know, and be a physician's assistant when I got older and be in the medical field. And then I went to go and see a medium for the first time myself after pushing my abilities away, and it completely changed my life. And I started doing this as a hobby. I would start reading for, you know, people in the back of a hair salon for $5 and $10 a reading. Do you remember those days?
Yes, those were nice days. We had fun.
We did have fun. We still have fun.
Yes,
we still have fun.
I love working with you.
I love working with you too. So we started reading for people in the back of a hair salon. Well, I did, for $5 and $10, and then we did house parties. And
then it grew to the radio, TV.
Yes, and to having a TV show on E! And it's so crazy because I remember back in the day, I didn't even have money to put gas in my gas tank. Aww. Like, remember that? Yeah. I worked like literally two jobs. I just did it because I loved it, and I still do. And you know, it was never about the money or the fame or anything like that. And all of a sudden, this just grew. So I feel very blessed to share my story with you because, you know, fame didn't come overnight to me. Success didn't come overnight to me. It was something that was a challenge. And, you know, in the early years, it was tough. So I start the book in the early years. I also talk about something that was really deep and personal to me. And that was high school, because when I was growing up, and this is why me and Alexa get along so well. We have I have a chapter about her in here about soulmates as well, because you are my soulmate.
Oh, you're mine. I love that chapter.
When I was
cried.
Oh, you cried when you
read? Yeah, it was beautiful.
All right, no spoiler for them. No spoiler for them.
I won't.
So when I was in high school, I was really, really bullied, like severely bullied. People didn't understand me. They didn't accept me. They didn't accept me for who I was and how I was. So I talk about the challenges that I overcame, you know, with bullying and what a serious topic it was and how hard it was for me. But, you know, I was just in an interview today and talking about this, that, you know, even though it was so tough and even though it was hard, that I wouldn't change a thing because it made me who I am today. It made me so compassionate for the people that I meet with and the people that I talk to every day. So I talk about that. I also talk about how I got back into being a psychic medium because I pushed it away for years and years and years. And it just so happened that I went to go and see a psychic medium myself. And that really just roller coastered, you know, with things. And when I first started deciding that I was going to be a medium, or that I was going to get back into this and do this professionally or start seeing people, I had to break the news to my dad. And if you guys have watched my TV show, my dad was out of my life for 21 years because he was in the Navy. So it was just me and my mom with my sister. So my dad didn't understand that I was a medium or that I could see and hear dead people because he wasn't around it when I grew up. You know, it wasn't a time when we had Facebook or Skype or, you know, video phone calls or FaceTime. Yeah. So there's a whole chapter in there about how I had to break the news to him and how I had to tell him that, you know, I was a medium. And in the beginning, he wasn't supportive. You know, as you saw on the TV show, it was the first time that he actually came to one of my live events. So we talk a lot about that because it is hard when you're telling other family members or coming out to other family members that you're a medium and explaining this. And then I also talk about dealing with skeptics and non-believers and just negative people in general. And what I love about this is that I wanted this book to be very different than any other book that you read. You know, I know that sometimes it's hard to relate to a psychic medium if you're not psychic yourself. So I put in each chapter some of my most powerful readings and also tools that you can use within your daily life, how to avoid negativity, you know, how to deal with bullying, how to deal with negative situations, and tools that you can use, such as manifesting and goal setting, in ways that you can be successful in your life. And these are the same tools and techniques that I've used in my life and that you've taught me and that grandma has taught me. So I think you're really gonna be excited about that. And then also, this is a topic, and I wanna know in the comments, this is a topic that it's very polarizing, you know, when I talk about this. And that's, there's a whole chapter about this, about Ouija boards and psychic protection.
Yes.
What do you think of the Ouija boards?
I don't use a Ouija board.
Were they ever allowed in the house?
Grandma maybe had one, but we never used it.
See, now I was
someone
told that
gave it to her as a gift.
Oh.
It wasn't that she went out and bought it. Someone gave it to her as a gift because it was a board game, kind of. But my mother never used it. She did not like that.
It's not good.
She always says, don't open up the channel.
Right. Because what I was taught and what my mom was taught, and we always go by, you know, what my grandmother did, is that, you know, this is something I don't like to talk about. But, you know, if I was going to write this book, I had to talk about all sides of things, is that there is both a positive side of psychic ability, but also a negative side of psychic ability as well. Just as though that there's good people and bad people in this world, you know, there's also a negative side as well. So I wanted to cover that about Ouija boards and about being very careful about opening up doors and portals.
But you know, we always pray and meditate before we do readings.
Thank you. That's one thing that I didn't talk about. So
there's... That's actually a question here.
Oh, all right. Well,
how you get prepared for your readings. Yeah.
We're going to talk about that. So there's also protection techniques that you can use, because I do believe in psychic protection. You know, it's something that we use, and you won't find me playing with the Ouija board. So then I also have a chapter on soulmates and how to find the perfect person for you, as I did with Alexa. And then also what it's like when you die, transitioning to heaven and the afterlife. And then chapter 12, which is one of my favorite, loose ends and unfinished business. Mm. How souls are able to move on and take care of the things that they lost here in this world. And then one of the things that I love is chapter 13 is Lights, Camera, and Spirit. How my TV show, Meet the Frasers, came to be. And I think that you'll really enjoy reading that chapter. And then also, one last thing, I added a bonus chapter, chapter 13, which is questions that you can ask the psychic medium. So everything that I didn't answer, I went on Facebook and I took all of your questions and all of your comments and I put it into chapter 13. So that's my book. It's called When Heaven Calls. It just got released today. So you do not have this copy. Just to let you know, you do not have this copy. So make sure that you head on over, because this is the one time only that you can get a live autographed signing from me. Head on over to that link up top. Again, that link is
premiercollectibles.com/heavencalls.
If you don't know how to spell Premier Collectibles, like I don't know how to spell Premier Collectibles, you can go up to the top and click the link. And thank you to my team at Simon & Schuster, who edited this book and edited my very bad grammar, spelling, and punctuation. And I also want to apologize to all my Facebook fans for my grammar, spelling, and punctuation. But there's one good thing that comes out of this. You really know that I really do write my own posts, that nobody writes my posts.
Absolutely. I can vouch for that completely.
So when you see a misspelled word or something, don't get upset. Just know it was really written by Matt Fraser, okay? I don't have people writing my posts, so that's a good thing.
Yeah.
So now, because all the questions are coming in, I want to get to as many questions as I possibly can. I brought my mom here to help as well, to help answer your questions, because I know that you guys love her. We're going to get to some of your questions, and I see that Donna's asking right now how she can ask a question. You can ask a question by purchasing your copy of When Heaven Calls by the link up above, and it will ask you it'll ask you what question you would like to submit, and that's how we get them. So I'll be signing them. So get your questions in, because... here we go. What's the first question?
All right. So first question comes from Deborah from Bridgewater, Massachusetts. Hello, Deborah.
Oh, you know what? I'm going to sign these while I'm answering the question.
Okay. Oh, even better. So Deborah asked you, has there ever been a message you did not want to give a person?
All the time. Because, you know, what happens is that when you're doing this work, you know, sometimes souls come through that you don't want to hear from, but that you most need to hear from. But there's one thing that you always taught me that I still use in my readings today, and I talk about this in my book, is that even though it might not be something that you want to hear, sometimes it's something that you need to hear. And my mom always taught me one thing: speak the truth, but always come from a place of love. And if you come from a place of love and you come from a place of wanting to help that person, then there's nothing wrong with what you're saying. You know, right. You know me. You know how I read on TV. I don't sugarcoat things. I don't. I can't do it.
But you don't say anything negative either.
Well, yeah. Spirit will only tell you things that you can, not that you can avoid, but you can change.
Right.
So they're not going to tell you, you're going to go out and get a divorce tomorrow. Or your mom won't come through and say, well, you're going to go and get a divorce and there's nothing you can do. She will tell you different ways that you can help your marriage before that starts to happen. And that's why these messages are so amazing. So yeah, that there's some times when I do still have to say bad news. One of the things in the chapters that I can talk about, it happened with my own mom. Remember when my mother had cancer?
Yes. Oh my God. So, do you want me to tell the story?
I'll tell the story, because you tell the long story. I'm going to tell the short story. So my mom was going in and went for her, we were big activists in breast cancer. So you went every year for your mammogram, not a problem. But there were a couple of times when the mammogram machine, however it worked, screwed up and had she had to go back and have it redone.
Right.
So long story short, my mom went and got a call, as she did a couple years earlier, and it was like, hey, you know, we think that there was something I found on your imaging. You know, you need to come back and redo it. So my mother calls me up and she goes, you say to me, I'm so upset. I can't believe I got to go back and do this again. This is like the third time that they screwed up my mammogram. I'm not going this year. So right away, I sensed Grandma Mary, and I told my mom, I was like, Mom, you got to go.
Yes.
I just feel like you got to go. You have to go. You know, Grandma's here. She's telling me you got to go, that they found that this is something there. But what?
But it can be corrected.
But it can be corrected. So she went and
what? And you went with me. You were right by my side.
Yes, I was. And I went with my mom, and thank God, yeah, to this day. Right. It was, well, and they found it at, it just started. It was like the size of a pea.
So
was
they it had, not? Yes. And they had me, I went that day to have my operation, and as they're wheeling me into the operating room, Matthew's there, and he's going, Ma, do you feel okay? Are you strong? Are you strong? Because everything's going to come out all right with this operation. I went, yes. He goes, good, because next year you're going in again, and you're going to have it done all over again. And I'm like, what? And I did. The next year I had lung cancer, and I had to go and have another operation, but thank God I am cancer-free.
Well, this is for you, Deborah. It's all signed, so I'm going to put this all aside here. I want to get on to the next question, because I'm going to be here all night signing books. I don't care if I'm here till 5 in the morning. You don't understand.
Yes.
I promised you signed books. We're going to get all these signed, whether I'm camera or off camera. Someone's just going to have to go and get me a coffee. Like, get me a box of Joe from Dunkin' Donuts, and this psychic will run on steam.
So
Thank you, Deborah, for that question.
Sorry. Next question is Denise from Smithfield, Rhode Island. We have to get Rhode Island in there. That's where we live. Has there ever been a time when you're around a group of people, like doing a show, and no one from the other side reaches out? What happens if you can't get a reading for someone? Does the deceased need to be ready to speak to the living world?
So that is actually a really good question. So it's never happened that I have gone in front of a group of people and have not been able to get a message, because there's always someone there that wants to talk and wants to communicate. Sometimes it might not be the person that you want to hear from. You know, you might be looking for a grandfather to come through, but yet our old friend comes through from high school. But, you know, mostly I always, you know, there's always somebody there to speak. It's never happened that I've gone to an event or whatnot that there's not somebody that's there. But there are some reasons why some people get messages and other people don't.
Right.
You know, do you want to talk a little bit about that?
Well, they're not, the people that don't receive messages are people who are not ready to hear what the other side has to say. They just, you know, they're in too much pain, so they can't do it. They can't get a message.
And the other thing, too, is that sometimes, you know, not only you might not be ready, but they're only going to come through with the message if it's meant to help you. You know, if you're going through too much grief and you can't live your life, and they feel like that delivering a message is just going to make you search for more answers or not live your life, then they won't deliver it. They'll wait until you're at a point in your life when you're a little bit more ready. Or sometimes what happens is that, and I talk about this as well in my book, is that there is a transition period. When you first pass to the other side, it's almost like changing houses here in this world. The same way that we have to get our electricity turned on and we have to have the boxes unpacked, and the same way we have to move ourselves in is the same way that your loved ones have to get settled in heaven. Because when they first transition onto the other side, that's when they're meeting friends that have passed, loved ones that have passed, pets that have passed. Even your pets make it to the other side.
There's a lot of questions about pets, actually.
Oh, really? We're going to get into that, too. But for now, thank you for submitting that. This says, always trust in the signs. And I really want you to believe that, because the signs are all around us. So pay attention to the signs. They are always right there. And listen to the messages that your loved ones are sending you. You can put that over there.
Next question is Frances from San Gabriel, California. Ooh. And she asks, I like this question. Would you recommend reading this book before your first one?
I would. Because, so here's the secret, okay? Is that when I wrote my first book, it's not really an actual book. It was actually an ebook, and then we just printed it because it was just easier for people to read. So it wasn't a full-on detailed book. It wasn't anything about my life. It really just focused on ways to connect with the other side, where this takes you through everything. It takes you through my backstory, what it was like growing up psychic, what it was like, you know, what it was like hearing voices, what it was like growing up with this ability, how my mom's ability differed from my ability, you know, what heaven is like, what it's like when you died, why your loved ones are trying to reach you, how to deal with skeptics, the most powerful readings, and more importantly, the lessons that I've learned from the other side. So I would definitely recommend this one. because I got to tell you guys, it took me a year to write this, and I put my whole heart and soul into this. And thank you for putting up with me, by the way.
It's easy.
Because there was a whole year of don't come downstairs, don't distract me, I'm writing this, I'm taking care of this.
Like hours and hours.
And I'm going to tell you a little secret about this book, too, is that I am terrible, as you know, with writing. I cannot write to save my soul. God bless my English teacher, because I don't know how she dealt with me. So I recorded this whole book. I had a live transcriber, and I had a woman who actually knew how to write, and I told her everything that I wanted in the book, and she wrote it down for me. So when you read this book, it's really going to sound like I'm speaking to you. It's not just like, and then this happened, and then this happened. It's really in my own voice, which you'll hear when you read it, because it'll sound like I'm talking to you, because literally, that's how the book was made, is me just talking, because you know, I'm Italian, and if I can talk to dead people, I can definitely talk to somebody who can write the book for me. Definitely. So who's this going to? What was the name?
There was no name.
Oh, there's no name on that one?
Nope. Next question is Sherry from, oh my goodness, Naugatuck, I want to say, Connecticut. Hopefully that's right. When a baby passes and the soul is lost, does that child go with a family member who has passed before? And is it traumatic for the spirit to tell you and relive how they passed away?
Yes. So this one says your loved ones are always with you. So this is going out to the next person.
Thank you.
And who is this one for again, the name?
There's no name.
No, the name of the person.
Sherry asked a question.
Yes. So know that one of the things that I want you to know is that anytime that you lose a loved one, what comes from God goes back to God. So they don't want me to put the names in here because they don't want me to mess up who's being sent out. Okay. But the thing is that I wanna know who I'm talking to when I'm speaking. So what comes from God goes back to God. So anytime you lose a loved one, whether it be a miscarriage, whether it be an abortion, whether it be a termination, no matter how a soul is lost, stillborn birth, they will still come through. And yes, it's a very good question. They do wait with the loved one that had passed on. Actually, what's so crazy is that a few moments ago, I had a reading here at Simon & Schuster, and a woman's mother came through, and she came through with her baby that was lost. And it was actually a twin that didn't make it, that she didn't even really know about. But when she got to the other side, she was there with her, you know, with that daughter that had passed on. So even though she didn't get to know her, it was a twin that was, you know, unborn or never got to be born because it passed beforehand. That soul is still on the other side. And you know what else has happened? Just to let you know, because we really start our soul journey on the other side and in heaven. So what happens is that before we even get here in the physical world, we start on the other side. That's how come when I'm doing a reading, I can tell somebody you're having a girl or you're having a boy. Like I was just doing a reading on the talk show E-Daily News, E-Pop.
Daily Pop,
thank you. Daily Pop. I don't even know where I am half the time. I'm halfway between this world and the next world.
Right.
So I was on E-Daily Pop and Carissa was on there and her grandmother was like, oh, she's having a baby girl. And I was like, oh, your grandmother says you're having a baby girl. She's like, how did you know that? And I'm like, well, because your grandmother already has that soul on the other side. She already sees that. So you meet your loved ones even before you come here in this world. It's like, isn't it crazy to think that?
I was just thinking that in my head. That is crazy.
Like, you ever have that feeling like you say to somebody, like, I've known you forever. I feel like I've known you forever. Like, we say that all the time to one another.
I know, we do.
Like, we actually met each other beforehand on the other side.
Really?
Yeah. Isn't that crazy? Like, I don't remember meeting you. You don't remember meeting me.
Oh, no, I don't remember. We were baby?
I was a soul. Like, it's just like you. We met each other. Like everybody I'm talking to on Facebook right now, I met all of you. So if you've ever had that experience, you know, leave it in the comments. Let you know it's kind of like a deja vu. But yeah, it does happen. We always start our journey on the other side. So.
So I guess speaking on the same topic, so Jane from Stoneham, Massachusetts says, Do you hope someday when you have children that they have your gift?
You know, how do you feel about that?
Well, because I'm not a psychic, it's a little mixed for me because I know how difficult it was for you and your mom knows how difficult that was for you raising a child when, you know, you were just so scared. And I don't know if I'd be able to handle like my child being so scared, but I feel like that's where you would come in and you would be able to do exactly what your mom did for you and calm them down and say, look, this is normal, you're like daddy, you know.
Do you feel upset because Maria doesn't have the gift? My sister, because my sister, yeah. I had that grew up being psychic. By the way, this is Fiwa says, I'm always know that your loved ones are always with you. So,
we had a special connection. We always understood one another. We always seemed to know what the other
Wait
one was
Wait a minute,
was
that wasn't
thinking.
The question that I asked you.
No, I know, but I'm just saying that, do I feel that Maria, do I feel bad Maria doesn't have the gift? In a way, I do, because we don't have the same bond that I have with you, because we have a special connection.
Yeah.
I don't know how else to say
it. No, that's
it. It's not that I don't love her.
It's exactly right.
I do love her, but she doesn't have our bond.
Right. That is true. That is true, because we do have a bond, because my mom is the only one that could understand, you know, the things I was going through.
And we feel what each other feels.
And, you know, I think I would have a stronger connection with my sister if she had the psychic gift as well. Because I feel like half the time I'm talking about things, they're talking about people who have departed. My sister's like, looking at me like, what?
Yeah.
Like, where did that come from? Or, like, she doesn't understand because she didn't grow up with it.
Right.
I guess, you know, to answer the question, I got to tell you that I think I would want a psychic child.
Yeah.
Because you know what? I've seen people who, even if they're not reading,
mm-hmm.
like even if they're not going and actually reading people or doing what I do in a event setting.
Our legacy lives on.
Well, not just that, but I just think it can help you within life. Like, for example, I know many psychic people who don't do what I do.
Right.
But they're insanely psychic and they do other things. For example, I know one of my clients is a psychic, but they're a veterinarian. And it comes in really handy because she's a psychic medium, but when somebody brings in their dog that's sick or a pet that's sick, she's able to sense what's going on with that animal the minute they walk through the door. Without doing an x-ray, without doing anything, she knows, okay, that dog has stomach cancer or this dog has whatever. So she uses it in a different way. She's still helping people, but her calling is just different. So to answer that question, I think I would.
Yeah, me too.
And you know what? I think I know how to handle it better. You know, I've seen...
Right.
And we live in a different world now. We live in such a different world than even when I was growing up. Like, I remember when I was a kid, you know, and I talk about this too, is that when I was growing up, people used to say to me, like kids didn't know what I was talking about. They would go home and tell their parents, and their parents would say, you know, oh, Matt's making it up. He really doesn't see dead people. He really doesn't see his grandmother. Oh, honey, you know, that's just, you know, fictitious.
Right.
And now all of a sudden, it happens where everybody is more open to talking about signs and speaking about their loved ones. So I think that that's really important too. So if you guys are just tuning in, we're in the middle of a live book signing because my new book, When Heaven Calls, just got released today. That's why I'm all dressed up for you. We got the angel wings on. I got these two people in uniforms here, my mom and my fiance, Alexa. So we are signing your books right now on YouTube and Facebook. We have questions pouring in. So head on up to the link above, click on order, submit your question, and I'm going to be here all night signing books. I don't care. Get out the toothpicks. Put my eyes up like this because I will be signing all these books. I have to get them out to you. And we already have a ton of orders coming in and a lot of questions here. So I want to make sure this is the one-time thing. We're only doing this one time here on Facebook. So if you want a signed copy, head on over to that link up top. Doesn't matter where you are in the United States. If you can see me, I can see you. So head on over to that link. And we'll have your questions. If you can't, head on over to the link. Can you tell them where to order?
Absolutely. It's premiercollectibles.com/heavencalls. So next question. This one's kind of fun. This is from Debbie in Kings Park, New York. And I think this one's kind of funny because you go over this a lot during the TV show. Because in our TV show, Meet the Frasers, he does a lot of funny readings and brings a lot of joy to those readings. So she says... Do departed loved ones get to dress any way they want on the other side?
You better believe it. You better believe it. Especially because if I don't get to wear this in heaven, I'm going to be pissed. I got to tell you.
I think this would be cool to talk about when you saw Joan Rivers in a reading.
Yes. So there was this one time when I met somebody who, I did a reading for somebody who knew Joan Rivers. And she came out in heaven in this beautiful, sparkly, like, you know, ruby red outfit. And was so full of life, and it was just, it was amazing. It was amazing. Because like the same Joan Rivers that I saw on TV that would be all sparkly and dolled up and beautiful and whatnot. I mean, let me tell you something. She looked damn good in heaven. I didn't know that Botox carried over to the other side because she had not a wrinkle on her face.
Wow.
But no, what really happens is that when you go to heaven, it's not really that you dress the way you want, but the way that you want to be remembered or the way when you felt good, that's how you come through in spirit. Mm-hmm. So yeah, your energy, you leave your physical body behind. But like, for example, if somebody passed who was in a coma for 20 years, when I go to do a reading for that person, I will see them 20 years earlier before they were in the coma, back when they were looking their good, back when they were looking their best. It happens a lot of times when people pass of like, you know, ALS or Parkinson's and they're not able to walk and you know, they have a really, really rough time leaving this world. I'll see them before they got sick. And you know how they wanted to look when they were strong and they were healthy and when they were vibrant. Yeah. And it's amazing. I love that. And I loved Joan Rivers because I love when people come through with their personalities. And she was really a very funny soul to talk to. So I didn't get to meet her here in this world, but I got to meet her in the afterlife, which was pretty amazing.
That is amazing. Next question is Dawn from Candy in New Hampshire. She asks.
You can pass that over.
Yes, I absolutely can. Are you able to turn off the dead, or is it something that is always present to you, and are you just used to the spirits being there?
Oh, thank you, Dawn. Hmm. So I gotta tell you, as you see on my TV show, I do try to live a normal life. I do.
Try.
I try.
Keyword.
And you know, when I was a kid, it was really hard for me because, and that's why I wanted to really talk about the early years of my book, because when I was a kid, literally, it was like something out of The Sixth Sense. Like my bedroom, like bed used to shake. Like they would be yelling in my ear. I would sense and feel them. Like they would not leave me alone. And it always felt like there was a soul breathing down my neck. And the more that I would try to escape them, the more that I just tried to go to bed, the more that I tried to push the voices away, the louder and stronger they became. Mm-hmm. I know, it was scary. Oh, it was so scary.
For a young child.
But you know what? I don't have that anymore. I don't have spirits knocking down. I mean, do you have spirits knocking down? Once in a while, you do.
Once in a while, but not too often.
But, you know, they don't, and me too, like sometimes they'll pop in, but I don't have spirits shaking my bed. I don't have them busting down the doors. I don't have them going and yelling in my ear at night. Why? Because they know that I'm open to speaking to them now. Before, they used to do that because they couldn't get my attention. I would push them away. I was blocking them. But now they know that, listen, you know, I can talk to him anytime I want. If, you know, it can wait till the morning, you know? Although sometimes if there is an urgent message, like it's happened to you, where sometimes you'll wake up out of a dead night's sleep and you'll hear from somebody in spirit. Like, and then a lot of times happens when somebody passes away. Mm-hmm. So like if someone that me and my mom, like a distant relative, if they pass away, it's happened where, you know, all of a sudden I'll wake up in the middle of the night and know that somebody had just died. You know, or something like that. But it's not a scary thing. It's just kind of them letting me know, like, okay, I made it to the other side. Don't worry about it when you get the news.
Right.
So that happens. But no, it's not scary anymore. I do. I kind of have the ability to turn it off. You know, they're always there. They're always around. So it's just like when you're living in a house with different people. You know, if you're living in a house and you have 5 or 6 family members, you're not always talking to them, but they're always around. And when they need you for something, they know that they can just walk into your room and say hello. And they're there.
That's a good way to put it.
Isn't it a good way to put it?
I like that. Next question is from Agnes in Danbury, Connecticut. You've been there. Wonder if she's been to a show. She asks, how far away is heaven?
Oh, that's a really, really good question. This is for Dawn. It says, always believe. That's for you. And push that over. Yeah. So this is... What's the name again? I'm sorry.
Oh, I'm sorry. Agnes.
Agnes. Okay. Agnes. Hi, from Danbury.
Yes.
Hi, Agnes. So that's a really good question. So the thing is that we live in the physical world, which is everything is physical. This book is physical. This table is physical. You know, everything is physical. But when we pass, we become energy. So we leave our physical body behind and we take on an energy form. And when we go to the other side, you know, world needs to meet soul. So the world that we enter is also an energy space as well. So this really, really freaks people out. Does it freak you out? Because Alexa's afraid of death until she met me. Are you still afraid of death? Did reading this book help you?
No, it did. You help me every day get over that fear, definitely. I like to learn a bit more about it now, if that makes sense.
But you wouldn't talk about it before.
Right.
Alexa was afraid of everything before.
About it. Yeah.
I'm lucky.
My own shadow.
Yeah. So the thing is that to answer your question is that, you know, it's when everybody gets all nervous when I talk about you being a spirit because they think of this, they think of air, they think of nothing, but it's not like that at all. And here's why. So heaven is an energy space. It's not far away. It's not a planet. It's not an outside world. It's really among us. Right. And the way that I want you to think about this is that think about a dream. Okay, the same way that you enter into a dream and you can touch things and feel things and you can see people in a dream is the same way that heaven is. Why? Because your thought waves are energy. Your dreams are energy. So when you go and you enter into that space of being into a dream, how many times have you had a dream and you can see people and you can touch them, whether it be your departed grandmother, whether it be your departed mom, whether it be a friend that had passed, or just somebody that you're thinking of, and you can touch them and you can feel them. And in that dream, it is real. I mean, I've been in dreams where literally I have felt things. I've felt coldness. I've felt people's breath.
Really?
Yeah, you never had that?
Never.
Have you had that?
That's crazy.
Have you had this?
I know. I want to know. Maybe it's a psychic thing.
Maybe it's a psychic. I don't know. But leave it in the comments below. Have you felt this? Have you had very vivid dreams like this? Because I have.
I'm really curious now.
Remember when the spirit was going?
Yeah.
When we were in bed?
Yes.
When you were little?
Yes, that was the times when spirit, we could feel the breath of a spirit. That was different. This, I'm talking about dreams. I'm talking about dreams. When you're dreaming, and you, the same way that you can see somebody in a dream that has departed, and you can see them in physical form in a dream, that's the same way that you are in spirit. So I don't want you to think of your dad as a cloud or as your mom as a cloud, because they're not. Mm-hmm. They're just as we are right now in heaven. You can see them. They are physical. So just because of that, don't think that they're not physical.
Yeah, that was something I never understood, that, like, heaven's basically, like, not like this, but sort of, but it's just up there.
Well, it's like, we don't have to pay taxes in heaven. Yeah. That's the nice part.
But,
you know, and the nice part is that in heaven, my book is only $1.99. Just kidding about that.
Well,
but, I have to ask Alexa, I feel like I'm in Harry Potter and like she's like the mortal, so I always have to bounce things off of her. Does that make sense to you how I explain that? Did I do a good job of explaining that?
Oh, yeah, you did. Yeah.
Is there anything else I could explain? Could I explain better? Put it in the comments. Can I explain that better?
Yeah. Sometimes you don't do a great job explaining. I think that's why you're asking.
Did I just feel a bus run over me?
No, but...
You're supposed to be hyping me up here.
Yeah. Well, speaking of... once again, if you're just tuning in, this is Matt Fraser. He's signing his book copies of his brand new book. It came out today. When Heaven Calls... Life Lessons from America's Top Psychic Medium. That's a long title. I had to go back to it. If you want to order it and get yourself a copy and a signed copy, you can go right to premiercollectibles.com/heavencalls.
Or click the link up top. So we are answering your questions of the afterlife. And every single person who goes to this link up top will get a signed copy. This is a one-time thing that we're doing just for all the Facebook and YouTube followers. It's a really special day today because it's the launch of the book. We're at the Simon & Schuster World Headquarters. Woo. So if you click the link up top, I will spend here. Like basically, they're wheeling in my cot right now. I'm going to be sleeping here and signing books till the morning. So make sure that you get your questions in. And we're gonna get them into the mail as quickly as we can. Yeah. So I want you to see here. I got all dressed up for you today. I got all dressed up.
This was my idea.
Was not her. Or was it
yes,
your idea?
Yes, it was. Remember, I was like, listen, because Matt and I are very into fashion.
I got my nice shoes on for all of you.
Yes.
Look at this. I'm styling. You can't see the whole outfit, but I'm doing it really good just for you because I'm really excited.
Yeah.
All right? So I just want you all to know that. All right. So moving on to the next question, because you have 15 minutes to get your orders in. That's 15 minutes.
Keep them coming. 15 keep minutes. Them coming. If you want When Heaven Calls... premiercollectibles.com/heavencalls.
I'm gonna sign this while you. Oh my God! I just put a little ink mark on my blazer.
Oh God!
Do we have a dry cleaner in the house?
So I think this next question is really great, and I think it definitely goes with the book and what you were explaining or what you actually put in the book. For example, tools for life. This is question is from Betty from West Palm Beach, Florida. Is it possible to learn how to receive messages, or is it a gift you must already possess?
So here's the thing, is that I can't teach anybody how to just see dead people. But what I can teach you to do is I can teach you how to tap into your own ability, because we all have a way to connect with our loved ones. I mean, you get signs from your people that have passed on all the time. Alexa's a big believer in signs.
Huge. I think anything is a sign. I'm like, oh my God, a cloud. My grandma. Yeah.
But you know what? But listen, it's true. It's that anything that you think is a sign is a sign. But what I want to let you know is that you all have a very, very specific way to reach heaven. And it's all different. You know, just like my mother's gift, psychic ability, is different than my gift. And your mother's gift is different than yours. you know, you too have a way to reach your loved ones, and it's in these ways. One, through signs, okay? Two, through feelings. Three, through thoughts. Four, through dreams. Five can be through...
smell.
Smell, thank you. So whether, when, I mean, I believe in all kinds of signs. If you all of a sudden smell your grandmother's Gina Tay out of nowhere, and that's the cologne she used to wear, or the perfume she used to wear, that's a sign from your loved one. If all of a sudden you keep finding pennies, dimes, nickels, and your dad was a coin collector, that's a sign from your dad. If all of a sudden you go and, you know, you start to see their special number written on license plate, written, you know, on billboards or whatnot, that's a sign from your loved one. And this is the question, I see this coming through in the comments. Somebody's asking, well, how do I know it's really a sign? The way that you know it's really a sign is that when you're going and receiving these signs, if it truly, really is your loved one, it'll keep happening and happening and happening and happening. So it's not just gonna be that you're gonna see one random cloud and that's gonna be your grandmother. It's gonna be that you keep seeing the same cloud formation, that same song on the radio, keep having that same reoccurring dream, keep picking up those same random pennies until you're like, okay, I know it's you, Dad, or okay, I know it's you, Grandma, or whatever. And that's why this book is so important, because it's ways that you can start your own conversation with heaven. Because people think that they need to see a medium to connect with your loved ones on the other side. And that's just not true. Don't get me wrong, I love seeing you, keep coming. But, but it really starts with you. And it really starts with understanding the ways that your loved ones are using to reach you, and understanding that you too have a gift, and that you too can connect with your own abilities and connect with the other side. It's a muscle. And you know, a lot of people who are artists are also very intuitive. You know, we all have different muscles, whether you sense, smell, see, hear, whatever. You can learn to receive messages. It's just in a different way. And there's no gift that's greater than another.
That's true, because ever since I've been with you, I've actually become really open to signs, and I feel way more intuitive than I ever was before. So that's really, really interesting. I love this question. This is from Tammy from Earlton, New York.
Ooh.
And I feel like this is another little sneak peek of your book, because you get very, very personal in When Heaven Calls.
Yes.
And they know every ounce of your day.
This book is signed and ready to go.
Oh, perfect. So Tammy asked, do you have a ritual before readings to allow only good spirits to come through?
You know, that's a really good question. Thank you, Tammy, for asking it. And hello and welcome to the book signing. So yes, I do. So the thing is that when I am doing a live event or I'm doing a reading, this is something that nobody knows, that we really don't talk about and we really don't share, but just because it hasn't come up, but I talk about it in the book as well. I tried to cover as many topics as I could, if you haven't noticed. So before anybody goes into an event space, before I even go out on stage, the first thing that I do is I go in the room by myself and I pray, I meditate, I put my energy into the room, and, you know, more importantly, I just take some time by myself to really get acclimated to the space, but also to say a prayer, because I only want to hear from positive, loving beings. And those of you who have been able to have a private reading with me, you'll know that before I go on the phone with you, or before me and my mom do a reading, the first thing that we do is we pray. You pray with your clients, right?
I pray, I open up the message with a prayer with my client.
Same thing with me. Same thing with me. Is that, you know, I've always, you know, known that my gift comes from God. Mm-hmm. So to me, I always start everything and end everything with God. So I always pray, and God can be many things to you know, many different people. So to me, I believe in the higher power. I believe in God. I pray before every event. I pray for my clients. I pray for their well-being. I pray for positive souls. You know, I pray to my angels. I believe in angels. I know that we have angels that are with us. My mom does the same. I got that from her. So yes, that's the way to keep us protected from negative souls coming in. Because if you're negative, I don't want to talk to you, whether you're living or dead. I just wish it sometimes, and you know what's funny, and I talk about this here too with the psychic protections, is that there's also a way that you can kind of say a prayer and do some rituals to keep negative people out.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
Like, you know, you can kind of put a border wall up to, yeah, keep the negative people and the negative souls away. That's how I like to think of it. Like, you know how we have borders and whatnot? Yeah. We can create an energy border to keep the negativity away from you. Mm-hmm. It's your, so we'll talk, that's being talked about in the book as well under psychic protection.
And I also have an angel garden in my yard.
Oh, yeah.
That I keep any negativity away.
That's right. Why don't you tell them a little bit about how to create an angel garden?
So the way I created an angel garden is I went and I bought a beautiful 5-foot St. Michael statue. And the reason why I did this is because one day St. Michael did come to me in a dream, because I was having random spirits coming around. And he told me to put him in my yard facing my bedroom window, which I did. And then he told me what flowers that he likes, which is purple lilac.
Thank you.
And I put it around. And I started praying to St. Michael, and I have him in my backyard. And he would always give me signs. Like I'm a walker, so I would go walking, and I would randomly see an angel statue in someone's garbage that they were throwing away. And I would pick up the angel, and I would take it home, and I would put it in my angel garden. So some of my angels are missing a hand, some have a half a feather, a half a wing missing, and I call them my garden of misfit angels. But they all give me protection, and I love each and every one of them.
And you can call upon your angels anytime that you need guidance or support,
yes,
or you need them there with you. And what I like to do, and people think I'm crazy, but I don't care, you know, is that I always call upon all the angels that don't have a job, or all the angels that need something to do when I need some help or I need some guidance myself. So we only have a couple minutes left. We're signing books like crazy. We're here at the world headquarters of Simon & Schuster. It's the live book signing for When Heaven Calls, my brand new book. This was just released today. So there's no way you have a copy unless you pre-ordered it. So that being said, if you'd like a signed copy, you can head up to the special link up top, and also you can visit
PremierCollectibles.com/heavencalls.
Psychic medium Matt Fraser, you're here with Alexa, my fiance, and
Mom, Angela.
And we're from the TV show Meet the Frasers. You know you know me from seeing me and hearing me give readings on TV and radio. And today I just read Jenny McCarthy, if you guys were listening, and it was pretty amazing. And now you can get a copy of my book right now. This is the first time that we're doing something like this at Simon & Schuster. And more importantly, this is your chance to get a signed copy. We can only do it for the people who are tuning in right now. So you have to head on over to that special link. Because that's it. I made a commitment. I'm gonna stay here all night long.
Well, actually, we have a little special segment at the
moment. Oh, we have a special segment. Oh, God bless.
So we're gonna play 22 questions in 2 minutes. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
So you have 2 minutes. We're gonna start.
Okay.
Ready. Who would you like to have dinner with, past or present?
Okay, Shia.
Oh,
definitely
Shia.
I love a Shia.
Two. Which one, Game of Thrones or Stranger Things?
I don't know either or, but I'll say Stranger Things because
either.
I don't watch either of those. Listen, when you talk to dead people all day, you don't watch the TV. Come on, I only have 2 minutes. Let's go.
Okay. What is your favorite breakfast food?
Oh, my
Coffee.
God.
You don't eat breakfast.
No, I do. I like a cinnamon roll. I love a cinnamon roll. A cinnamon bun. I love a Cinnabun. Mm-hmm. If you're listening, please sponsor me and send them to my house monthly.
What is your favorite genre of music?
Oh, my God. I love the oldies. I love an oldies. Yes, I do. I love, like, anything that makes you dance.
Hmm. Who was your idol growing up?
Who was my idol growing up? Oh my God, I don't know. Who was my idol growing up? Oh my God, I need more than 2 minutes to answer this. I feel on the spot. I'm getting all nervous. Oh gee. My idol growing up. Let's come back to that next.
Okay. What is your favorite international cuisine?
International cuisine? Well, it's not international to me, but I'd say Italian. I'd say my mother's eggplant parmesan, I love.
And meatballs.
And meatballs, but I don't eat meatballs out. Next. Because you don't know what they're putting in them.
We have about a minute left. What is your favorite candy bar?
My favorite candy bar? Oh my God, I love the cookies and cream.
Oh,
the cookies and cream
Hershey's,
one? Yes. The Hershey's cookies and cream.
Do you have a favorite season?
Yes, summer.
Okay.
I can live in summer.
What is your favorite childhood memory?
My favorite childhood memory. Oh my God, it's gonna be when my grandmother was alive.
Okay. Did you ever have an imaginary friend?
Or it could have been, did I ever have an imaginary friend?
You had many.
I had many, they were called dead people. I didn't realize they were imaginary. Well, they're really not imaginary, they were dead.
Probably only have a couple seconds left. Do you have a favorite animal?
Yes, I love a cat.
Yep.
I have 3 cats. Bengal cats.
And that was 2 minutes.
That was it? That was the 2 minutes?
That was it.
Oh, we can keep going. We can
okay,
guys,
we'll
okay.
keep going.
A higher power just told us keep going. All right.
Oh boy. What is your go-to workout?
Oh, I don't have one.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't have. Do I look like? I'll tell you my go-to workout.
Running
it's called
your mouth.
Are you kidding me right now? Now that you become my fiance, you think you can say this stuff?
You know that it's true.
I'll tell you my go-to workout. It's called Spanx. That's what it's called. I'm a big fan of the man Spanx. I'm wearing some right now. So that's my go-to work. I had to lose. I'll tell you a secret. I had to give up my gym membership because I was going to the gym only to use the tanning bed. So now I don't go anymore.
Yeah.
So that's it. All right, next.
Okay. What do you never leave home without?
My cell phone.
That's very true. Do you have a favorite superhero?
Do I have a favorite Superman. Definitely Superman because he can fly.
What is your favorite time of day?
Oh my God. I would love an afternoon. I hate a morning. I'm not a morning person.
No.
I am not a morning person. I hate the mornings. Don't talk to me in the mornings without my coffee.
Right. Have you ever ridden in a hot air balloon?
No, but I want to.
What is your favorite board game?
Monopoly. I love Monopoly.
You're so good at it, too.
I love it. Love buying them properties.
What are your favorite pizza toppings?
Definitely pepperoni, but I love a green pepper and olives. Mm. Yes.
Do you have a favorite teacher?
Do I have a favorite teacher?
Your EMT teacher, right?
Oh, yeah. My EMT teacher, yes. Anne, yes.
Do you like...
She's probably watching right now from Norwood.
Do you like movie popcorn with or without butter?
Oh, without. I can't do the butter. I'll be on the bidet after.
On the opposite. Who is your favorite author?
Oh, myself.
I knew that was coming.
Actually, you know what? I really liked a book. I really liked. So there was a book that I read that I loved. It was by Bill O'Reilly when I was a kid.
Oh,
I really liked that book. It was about who was looking after you, and I liked that book. Yeah.
And the last question for 22 questions in like 5 minutes.
Well, don't make fun. It's hard to do this.
Who has impacted you the most?
My mom. Definitely my mom. Because, you know, she was the first person that to teach me about psychic ability and to, you know, help me to understand this. So I thank you for that. I thank you for helping me to write this book. So if you're just tuning in, I'm Matt Fraser from the TV show Meet the Frasers. And I am a psychic medium. I'm here with my mom, who's also a psychic medium. And I just released my first copy of When Heaven Calls, my memoir, Life Lessons from America's Top Psychic Medium. You can get them by clicking on the link up top. I am here overnight at the Simon & Schuster office. There is nobody here but me, you, and an empty conference room, and some people here that are going to wait while I sign books and bring me lots of coffee all night long. So if you're in the area, please drop off Dunkin' Donuts, hazelnut, Cinnabuns, cinnamon buns, and we'll be there. Lots of caffeine.
Okay, so we pretty much have time for about one more question. So this
can we extend or no? Let's go for another 15 minutes because we got more people that have answers. I see all the more coming in.
All right, yeah. So for those tuning in, you can get When Heaven Calls by Matt Fraser at premiercollectibles.com/heavencalls.
So this is your chance. This is your chance. We're giving you another chance. I'm here to answer the questions. I'm ready. So head on up to the link. Click on the link above. Head on over. Get your copy. It'll say you can submit a question, and then there you go. And if there's one thing I'm going to promise you, I will get your copy signed.
Mm-hmm.
I will get your. My eyes might be crossed. But I will get your copy signed.
And there's a lot of orders coming in. There's a lot of questions coming in.
Ooh, so
we
QBC.
Are extending another 15 like minutes for you.
Let's extend to 20. Let's extend to 20. No one's going to say anything.
Okay, 20 minutes. So this is Linda from Waterford, Connecticut.
Ooh, hi, Linda. Let me sign this book for you while we're talking. Oh, this one's signed.
I love this question because she said, when we pass, do we reunite with our pets? I lost a cat in 2016 and I still miss her. We lost our cat, Lord, as well about 2 years ago. We still miss him as well. So I like this
question. Yes. What's so crazy is that there's this thing when you pass on, it's called, this is for you. There's this thing called the Rainbow Bridge, and it is real. And your pets do make it to the other side. And the crazy part is that they're the first to reach you when you get to heaven. Because soul recognizes soul. The reason why we're so connected to our pets is because our soul recognizes the soul in that animal. That's how we can tell if that animal is sick, if that animal isn't feeling well, if that animal, you know, is something off. It's because it's a soul connection. It's not just, you know, that's why we don't have that same connections with, you know, inanimate objects. We have only those connections with something that has a soul. So when that soul passes, what comes from God goes back to God.
I love that. So this is really interesting. This question's from Deborah from Portsmouth, New Hampshire.
Hi, Deborah.
This is a really interesting question. She said, do you see your deceased relatives? Like, for example, she said, does your grandmother come to you?
That's a really good question. Here's your book. It's all signed for you. So what happens is that, yes, I do see my loved ones, but you got to remember that loved ones will only come through when there's something that they need to tell us. So, for example, the last time I saw my grandmother, I talk about in the very last chapter, because she came through telling me that I was going to have this TV show and this TV show was going to happen. It was her way of supporting me from heaven and letting me know that this was going to take place and this was going to be the next step. So my grandmother was there to help me through that, just like your loved ones are there to help you. So yes, I do see them. I can't just sit and brew a cup of coffee and, you know, just start talking with my grandfather. I would love to do that, but they've already lived their life. They've already lived their journey here on earth, and what they want is for...
Papa gave you a message yesterday when he gave you...
Oh, that's right. Picture. That's right. They give me signs just as the same as they give you signs. So I can't just, you know, grab a cup of coffee and talk with them when I want. They have to come through. But, you know, they are always there through life events and through special times. And Alexa and I, as you saw, got engaged on Meet the Frasers yesterday. So there were some signs that I got yesterday from my grandfather that really made me, really made me happy. Because the reason why is that they want to come through in your life, but they don't want to disturb things. They don't want to take you off track. They just want to come in enough to say, hello, I'm here. You know, I'm by your side and not stress you out. You know, not pull you off of your life course.
Right. Let's see. This one's interesting. Dawn from Lynn, Massachusetts asks, do you ever get annoyed or frustrated with spirit and not want to hear from spirit sometimes?
No, but I get frustrated with my clients. Because there's sometimes when I deliver a message, and I talk about this in my book, not every reading is easy. You know, and there's sometimes when some people don't want to hear a message from their loved one, or they don't want to accept, you know, the message that a loved one is telling them. You know, I can deliver a message from your dad or from your mom or from whoever it is, but, you know, you have to accept the message that your loved one is giving to you. And sometimes there's some people that just don't want to hear it. You know, they don't want to hear from their loved one, or maybe they don't agree with the advice that their loved one is giving them. And that's really hard for me, because if your loved one is coming through, they're coming through for a reason. They're coming through because there's something that they want you to know. There's something that they want you to be able to help you with. There's something that they want to be able to pass on. So, you know, it's difficult when there's people in this world who really just don't want to listen. I think that that's the saddest thing.
Yeah. So this is a really interesting question, and I guess
who's
it would
this
be
from?
For the both of you. So her name is Beth A. from Newport, New Hampshire. Do you think your sister would/could have the ability if she opened up to it? And does everybody have the ability on some level?
Well, I mean, okay, you want to answer this? Go ahead.
I think
me and my mother are going to disagree with this. Watch.
Well, no, I think that Maria does not have the gift.
Right.
And she doesn't want the gift as well. And that's another thing.
You're absolutely right, because you know what? Speaking of this, they'll only come to the people that are going to listen to them. Like, they somehow, some way, they knew that me, you, and my grandmother, who was psychic, would listen to them.
Right, right.
But if you're not going to listen to them, they're not coming through to you.
Right.
True. Okay.
So I don't think that my sister would open up. And
no.
I think that, you know, you have to be a very special person to, you know, open yourself up and to listen to. It's a lot of time. It's draining. It's very draining on your energy. Very draining on your energy.
Right.
And, you know,
plus you take, you get the sad, you feel the sadness of the person that you're helping. So, you know, there's a lot of emotions and stuff that come with
it. Yes. That's for you.
Perfect. Thank you. There you are. I think these questions are getting more interesting and more interesting.
I love that. See, this is why we extended.
This question is from Jennifer from East Greenwich, Rhode Island. Hello, Rhode Island. We're not there today, but we live there. Are spirits stronger when they first cross over, and do they get weaker over time?
They do not. They get stronger over time. So what's so crazy about it is that, you know, the same way that you're learning to connect with your loved ones are also learning to connect with you. So they have to learn to channel in. They have to learn ways that they can reach you, ways that they can connect with you, signs that they can send to you. And that's the most amazing part, is that when you're connecting with spirit, you're also learning a new language. I'm learning a new language every day. I'm learning how to communicate with them, how to talk with them. And you could be too. I call it the language of spirit. Mm-hmm.
And also, too, sometimes the spirit, the way they first connect with you is they'll give you three knocks. It's always three knocks, and it would be either on your door or on your wall. That's when they first start to try to communicate with you as well.
Yeah, me and my mom noticed some of the things about when spirits first cross over and they come through. There's a lot of things that they'll do. So, for example, we've noticed some repetitions just through the readings that mm-hmm. we've done. Like, for example, right. when someone first passes, a lot of times you'll hear three knocks. You'll also be woken up at the same time every night, whether it be right. 3 a.m, 2 a.m, 4 a.m.
Exactly.
Also, what you'll notice is that things start to go on with electricity or, you know, with your radio or TV. And that's usually how your loved one first tries to come through to you. And I think the reason why is because they're not really quite sure how to channel yet. And I've even noticed it's harder for me as a medium to talk to souls that just recently crossed over because they really don't know what they're doing.
No. That's cute. So this is from Craig E. from Charlotte, North Carolina.
Hi, Craig.
When you do a reading over the phone, how do you see the loved ones on the other side?
This is a really, really, really good question. So the question is, this is signs and ready to go for Craig. People ask me all the time, well, and they ask you too, yeah. if you're doing a reading for somebody, like, for example, my clients are all international. They are, a lot of them, not all international, but a lot of them are international. They're in China, they're in Ireland, they're in Japan, they're in a lot of different places. So people ask, you know, well, how would you do readings if by phone? Well, the thing is that spirit is everywhere. I mean, even you guys have seen it when I do readings on the radio. When I'm doing readings on the radio, right, I'm able to connect with so many different callers because spirit is everywhere. So just because I'm not physically there with the person, I can still read them. And this is really important too, because if somebody says to you that they need to be in person with you to do a reading, then they're not connecting with your loved ones. They're reading you. They're looking to see, right. you know, how your hair is. They're looking at facial features or
jewelry.
If you're really connecting with spirit, you don't need to be with that person because, you know, as long as you're on the phone with them, as long as you have a direct connection with them, whether your backup is against the wall and you're speaking to them that way, you can get a message from their loved ones because they're with you. And the reason why they connect with me is not because they want to talk to me. It's because they want to connect with you and they know that I can just hear them. So I hope that answers your question. Doesn't matter where you are. And to be honest with you, I prefer phone readings better because I'm able to focus better without any distractions in front of me.
Right. So yeah, once again, we have about 10 minutes left. We extended our time a little bit because Matt's having so much fun signing books
for you. I love this right now.
So if you want When Heaven Calls, you can click the link or go to premiercollectibles.com/heavencalls.
And here's the thing. You will get a signed copy here tonight, okay? Well, not tonight, but I'll be signing them tonight. So you will get a signed copy. This I can promise you. So even if I'm not able to sign it on camera for you, I will be here. There is no stamp. There is me in this hand. And when at the end of the night, when I'm going like this, you'll see why. But I'm going to be signing as many copies as you submit and you order. So now is the time. Head on over to the link. That's it. You know, after the link is down, you know, that's all. So I want to make sure that you get your copies as quick and as fast as you can, because this is your opportunity to get a signed copy no matter where you are, no matter where you live. So we're also, I'm also going to keep answering your questions as we go along as well.
I'll be asking them. So this question is really cool, and I feel like you did touch about it in the beginning of this stream, but for those tuning in, this is a really great question. This is from Elizabeth from Malta, New York. Can spirit let you know if they approve or disapprove a situation or a person?
Oh, that's a really good question. A really good question. And yes, there have been times, that's for you, there have been times when spirit has come through and they have said that this relationship is not for you. And I have to tell them. You know, and let me tell you, it's hard. This is not an easy conversation to have. But, you know, I think that that's why my clients come to me and why my clients, you know, love coming to me is that, you know, your mom and your dad, when they pass on, they still are your mom and your dad. And they still want the best for you. They're not trying to live your life, but they want the best for you. So if you're in an abusive relationship, if you're with somebody who's really not into you, or if you're with somebody who is, you know, misleading you or whatever, they will let you know it. And at the end of the day, it's your choice. They're not going to tell you.
Freedom of will.
Right. They're not going to tell you, leave that person. But they will tell you, you know, so-and-so is cheating on you, or so-and-so is not being truthful, or, you know, so-and-so is not, you know.
Or they'll let you bump into that person, you know, when you're shopping or whatever, right, by accident. They do have a way of, you know, coincidence.
Right. So if they don't connect with me as a medium themselves, they will find a way to get the message to you, because coincidences don't happen, not in my world anyway. So yes, your loved ones, you know, at the end of the day, they want what's best for you. And what's so crazy is that sometimes, and this has happened with me in my life, I know it's happened with you at home in your life, is that sometimes what happens is that we don't know what's best for us in our life. And I think that that's what it is. Sometimes we feel something and we want something so strong right in that moment. And then later we're like, was I stupid? Like, really? That's what you say. Like, was I stupid? Yeah. But your loved ones in heaven all along are like, yep, I told you. Like, you know, I you should have seen it coming. Right. Yeah. You know, I think we've all experienced that. So even though right now you might feel like you're with the perfect life partner, you might feel like you're really on the right track, you know, those on the other side, remember, can see things much clearer than we can.
Right. Next question. Jacqueline from Hingham, Massachusetts. I don't know how you came to my attention. Do you think my loved one sent you to me?
I believe so. I don't think that, you know, anyone who's on my Facebook page, right? I know that you guys, thank you. I know that you guys just didn't end up here. I believe in coincidences. I believe in divine circumstance. And I know that all of you were sent to me somehow for a reason. And that's the reason why, one, I had to write this book. But two, the reason why I love doing things like this, because I love getting to know you. You know, the worst thing I don't like about doing this work is I hate traveling. The one thing that I love that keeps me going, that keeps me on the road every day, is all of you. It's getting to meet you. It's getting to know your stories. It's getting to understand who you are. And more importantly, getting to know your loved ones on the other side and helping you connect with them. That's what keeps me going. If I didn't have that, I wouldn't be doing this work. It's because of all of you that I love getting out on the road every single day. So I really do feel like it's a privilege to connect with all of you. I feel like it's a privilege to deliver a message to all of you, and a great honor. And more importantly, I do feel that every single person that has come to my shows and my events, you know, someone in spirit has sent to me. I believe that. I mean, there have been some crazy things that have happened. We had an event where in Maine, and I went to Maine, and the very first person that I read, she lost her son tragically. Her son came through, and at the event, she came up to me. She was the first one to get her book signed, and she says to me, I was the first one you read in that room. She goes, and I had to come and see you. She goes, I came across your website. She goes, and I'm coming here all the way from Ohio. She actually got on a plane. Do you remember that reading?
Yes.
She got on a plane from Ohio, came to Maine. You know, out of all the people in Maine that could have been read, the one woman from Ohio was read.
Yeah.
How crazy. Did her son send me to her, or send her to me? I believe so. Yeah. I believe so. I do. I have to believe it.
Next question is from Donna in Belleville, in Illinois. Do family members who have died know what is going on in your life if it is something bad that you really don't want them to know?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. You know what it is? I hate to say it. I don't know. Book sales might go down when I tell you this one, because I write about this in my book, and you're not going to like reading about this. It's going to freak you out. But like I said, I say it like it is. And, you know, I wrote this book to answer your questions and to be truthful. And your loved ones can see everything that you do. Everything that you do.
But they don't judge.
Everything that you do.
Right, but they don't judge.
Everything that you do.
What do I do?
But the thing is, you gotta remember, all right, before everybody starts freaking out online, let me just say this, and I talk about this, okay? Yeah. Is that it's like having security cameras in your house. I have security cameras in my house. I have them everywhere. Do I pull up the cameras to see what Alexa's doing during the day? No. Why? because I have no interest. One, I have no interest. What am I going to do? Sit there and watch you playing on your phone, watching TV?
I know.
But the other thing, too, is that I respect you. I respect your privacy. I'm not going to be looking and infatuated. Do I have access to that information? Yes. Just like your loved ones have access to everything. Right. But do you think that my grandmother or my grandfather watch me on the bidet every morning? Absolutely not. I can tell you. Do you think they watch me shower? Absolutely not. Why? Because they're not interested in that. You think that my grandmother wants to see that? I'll tell you one thing. When I die, I'm not watching anybody in the shower, anybody on the toilet, anything. I skeeve it. I have a hard time wiping my own ass. So I would never see any of that. So the thing is that your loved ones don't. They're not there. Just like they weren't here in this world with, well, I don't know, because my mother might be like that. So just like when they weren't here with binoculars looking in your windows to see what you're doing, they're not doing that on the other side. Because there are things that are far more important to them. They want to be there when you're having a child. They want to be there when you're walking down the aisle. They want to be there at celebrations. They want to be there at birthdays. That's what they're interested in. They're not interested in you, you know, reading a book and taking a dump on a Sunday afternoon. It's just, they don't care. So, you know, to answer your question, they have access to all that information, but to them, it doesn't mean anything.
All right, we are getting down to the last couple minutes.
Well, let me just say really quick. So if you guys are just tuning in, I am live right now at the Simon & Schuster World Headquarters signing your books because today is the first day. It is publication day of When Heaven Calls. Look at this, When Heaven Calls. When Heaven Calls, Life Lessons from America's Top Psychic Medium. Look at this. We have this whole wall behind me right here. I never thought that I would be in the Simon & Schuster World Headquarters, but I am, and I'm here with all of you, and I'm signing your books, and we're taking questions. So you still have time to submit your order. If you're seeing this video right now, it means that there is still a chance for you to get a signed copy. For those of you just tuning in, I made it my pledge that whoever signs a copy, I don't care if there's 10,000 copies, I will sign every copy. I will be here. They're going to wheel me out on the stretcher, but I will be here signing all the copies that I can. So make sure that you head on over to that link. Make sure that you order. And when you order, you get to answer a question as well. We might as well just go to 6:30. Is that okay?
Oh, my God.
Wait, we're only 10 minutes away anyway. Can we just go to 6:30?
7:30.
Oh, 7:30? What time is it?
7:20.
Oh.
It's only 7:18. We're good. 7:30. We're good. We're good. Go ahead.
Okay, this is very interesting. Sandy from Clarencetown, New South Wales. I think that's Australia, isn't it? Do you yourself
video. Yes.
Matt Fraser.
Wait, this is from where?
I believe Australia. It's New South Wales.
Oh, my God. We have Australia. Our first Australian fan.
Sandy.
This is what I was waiting for. Sandy. Thank you. Where is that? Where is that?
Sandy.
I don't know that song.
Yeah, from Greece.
That's before my time.
Right. Yes.
That's not a song, eh? Yeah, Sandy.
Yes,
oh,
yes.
Sandra D.
Yeah.
Look at me. I'm Sandra D. No, so we got Sandra from South Wales. Hello, hello. We don't know if that's Australia or UK because we're not good at geography here.
Oh,
where is that from? Where
I
is that? That is Australia.
Australia, I was right.
We have you, Ben. We're looking. Yes, if you're in another country,
I
you can order.
School.
This changes everything. If you're in another country, you can order. You can get when heaven calls.
Yes.
Yes. So you just can't get it in heaven. But you can get it in any part of the world.
She asked a very interesting question.
Okay.
Do you yourself, Matt Fraser.
Yes.
Get any messages to warn you of anything that you are doing incorrectly?
Oh my God, yes. Oh my God, yes. Listen. This is what happens, okay? Is that sometimes I do get messages of if I'm doing something incorrectly. There's sometimes when spirit will say, listen, you shouldn't do this, but you should do this if I'm making a mistake, which it doesn't really happen all that often. For example, the one thing that comes to mind is, and I like to talk about things that I wrote in my book so that this way when you read it, you'll understand what happened. So the one thing that really, really saves me was when I was working in Boston. I loved my job. I loved coming to work every single day. Mm-hmm. I just so enjoyed it. And then there was just this time when all of a sudden I got called to do work a detail at the Boston Marathon.
That's right. Yep.
At the finish line. Mm-hmm. And I was all excited because who doesn't want to leave the office? It was like a field trip, right? Like, okay, go down, work this, work a detail. The sun was out. It was a beautiful day. Go watch the Boston Marathon. Being an EMT, you really don't have to do anything. You're down at the finish line, you know, whatever. Okay, done. So I signed up to go, was all excited. And then the morning of, all of a sudden, I just felt so sick, and I just had this uneasy feeling like, don't go. don't go. And I just felt like the soul telling me, don't go. So I was feeling so overwhelmed and so nauseous and so sick that I'm like, you know what? I'm not going. I'm not going. I don't know why. I'm just not going. You know, I don't know why this overcame. I don't know why I heard this, but I'm like, you know, maybe something's going to happen. And then don't you know that that was the day that the Boston Marathon happened. Mm-hmm. And I was supposed to be there that day. And right. I know that if I was there, I would have gotten hurt or died.
You were right. You were I was supposed right to be the front.
Right in the front. So the first time ever, I called out of work, and then that had happened. Mm-hmm. And you know what's crazy is that the minute I called out, and the minute I wasn't going anymore, all those feelings stopped. So I know that my guardian angel protected me that day. And the reason why I'm telling you this is, and this is why I talk about this in this book, is that, God bless you. That's why I talk about this in this book, is that it's not about the my guardian angel just protecting me. It's that that same way that my guardian angel protected me that day, your guardian angel can protect you. As long as you listen, when you hear something from your loved one, when you're driving in the car and you hear something just tell you to slow down, listen to it. Listen to it. The more that you listen to your loved ones, the more that you're able to go and to understand the messages that they're sending to you. And more importantly, the more that they're able to send you messages. When you negate it and you say, oh, I'm not listening to that. That can't be my dad. That can't be my mom. That can't be whatever. That's like returning, that's like saying, writing return to sender on the envelope and shipping it back to heaven. But when you listen and when you open yourself up, you show your loved ones that they can reach you and you show them how they can connect with you. So, and they'll send you more signs. That's the best part about that.
Right. This is another interesting question. It's really cute, actually. Christine from Falmouth, Massachusetts.
Falmouth, not Falmouth. Falmouth.
Well, foul mouth. No,
oh,
foul.
Dear.
Foul.
Oh, dear.
Go ahead.
Yeah, foul.
I didn't say foul.
Oh, I sound like you said a foul.
Okay. She asked, do your loved ones miss you when they depart like we grieve and miss them?
They do, but it's a little different. You know, that's the crazy part is that, you know, when we lose a loved one, right? When we lose a loved one and they go to the other side, we miss them and we want to see them and we think about them. And, you know, it's... We say to themselves, we think of what they're doing in heaven, who they're with in heaven, what's going on in heaven, what's life like for them in heaven. But for them, they see us every day. So we miss them and we get upset, but they're able to see everything that goes on in our life. So they don't really miss us the way that we miss them, you know, because they're able to see everything. You know,
and all their pain is gone.
And all their pain is gone. Thank you. Yes, I forgot about that. That's the most important thing. When you pass on, you leave your pain behind. So they're not in pain. They're not upset. But they have a front row seat to everything that you're doing. So, you know, it's kind of unfair in the way. I always thought this was unfair. Right. I think it's unfair that they're able to see the, every single thing that we're doing. They're able to see everything that we're a right. part of. And they're able to see the things we're able to do in the future. But we're not able to see them. Hmm. Or at least we're not able to see them the way that we'd like to see them. You know? So I think that's really the tough part. So we are down to the last 5 minutes.
Woo.
Okay? The last 5 minutes. So if you haven't gotten your copy of When Heaven Calls, this is your opportunity. We only have 5 minutes left. These people, they're all lining up here. The lights are going to shut off and they're kicking me off. So this is it. If you haven't gotten your copy of Heaven Calls, head on over to the link. Alexis is going to give you that link. Head on over to the link at the top and click it or go to where Alexa tells you, order your copy. If you order your copy today, I will sign it for you. I'm going to be here all night long signing these books. So make me work. This is the first time that we're doing this, and this is the really exclusive event. This is for anybody who can't get to a live book signing, who is in different. We had people call in or write in from Australia. We had people write in from the West Coast, from the Midwest, wherever you are, wherever you're watching right now. You can get a copy of When Heaven Calls, my new book. It was just released today. So if you already have a copy that's not signed, maybe it got shipped to you today. You can also get another copy that's signed for yourself. You just have to go to the link up top from Pierre. Tell them where to go. I can't say this today. I don't know why I can't say this link today.
You can head over to premiercollectibles.com/heavencalls. And we're going to move on to some of our last questions. So Stacy from East Wallingford, Vermont. Do souls come back to Earth again for a new life? Are people reborn, and do we get another shot to get it right?
Oh, dear God, we were just talking about this, because you know what, I gotta tell you, I gotta be honest, being a psychic medium, I don't want to do this again. Once I go to the other side, I want to stay on the other side, but yeah. I gotta tell you guys one thing. If I have to come back as something in my next life, I wanna come back as something athletic. I don't know what that is, but that's what I wanna come back. What do you wanna come back as?
My cat. Well, they are so spoiled.
And wanna come back as a cat?
Like one of our cats.
This is why we can't have these conversations. This is why
because they are so spoiled. They get so much love and attention, and they don't have to do anything. They have no responsibility.
No, in all seriousness,
Mary Rose has never spoken of us coming back. She has never mentioned that to me.
That's my grandmother that had passed. Because we get all of our all the messages. So that when you read this book, it's going to be different than other psychic books that you read, because I was never taught to be a medium. My mom was never taught to be a medium. We learned everything through our own experiences, through our clients and the people that we've read for. So I've never had somebody come back and tell me, "Hey Matt, you know I'm a caterpillar in my next life, or I'm a butterfly." It just hasn't happened.
Right?
Could it have happened? Yes. And I do. I got to be honest with you. I do believe that we do come back, or we do. We are given the opportunity to come back if there was something, if there was a lesson that we missed within life. Maybe we missed meeting our soulmate. Maybe we missed doing something. I do believe we have another chance. But I'll tell you one thing. When I die one day, I am not coming back. I'm giving that on the record. So if my angels, everybody, once I go to the other side, I'm hoping that I'm doing all my life's work now. So this way I don't have to do it again. So, and that's one of the things that our loved ones teach us, is that if there's something that you're meant to do in life, your loved ones will help you. I know I was supposed to be in this chair. I know that I was supposed to be a psychic medium. Now I know. I know that I was supposed to be doing this work. I'm living my life lesson every single day. You know, Alexa, you live yours with empowering women, you know, to getting up on the stage, to being, you know, an icon to different people, and, you know, helping women through their challenges and their struggles and whatnot with being Miss Rhode Island and doing your title. My mom has helped people in her life as a medium as well. You know, and has raised me to be the person that I am, and my sister to be the person that she is. And you all have your goals and dreams that you can achieve as well, and your loved ones will help you. We have 3 minutes left. 3 minutes left. We're signing books frantically, and I will be here all night. I won't be here live all night, but you have 3 minutes to go and to get your books in. So get your books in now.
So next this is question. Another interesting question. Chris from Castle Rock, Washington.
CHRIS?
Yes. If you are adopted, do your biological parents or adoptive parents?
Oh, this is a good one. I love this.
Come
one.
Through or both?
So, here's the thing, okay? When you go and you are whether you're adopted. Oh my God, I can't get my thoughts straight today. Yeah, I cleared the 3 minute mark and now I'm getting all nervous. Yes. So the thing is that you're connected by two ways with people that are in heaven, by blood and through an emotional connection. So there have been many times that I've read for people that have been adopted, and yes, both sets will come through. And yes, you know what? I'll tell you, it's always very confusing for me as a medium, because I always have two sets of moms and two sets of dads. So I get very confused on who's the biological mother, who's the adopted mother, who's this, who's that. It's very, very hard to understand and to differentiate. But yes, that does happen. That does happen, because they're still connected to you and they're still your parents. But you got to remember that your adoptive parents, or the person that you think of as your dad or think of as your mom, is there. So when I'm doing a reading for somebody, even if you had a stepmother or a stepfather and they raised you, they will still come through to you as that, as your dad or as your mom.
All right. Well, after you sign that book, will you do the honors of wrapping up your signing?
Yes. Oh my God, I can't believe this. I can't believe this. I can't believe that I'm here with you all today. I can't believe that I'm going to be spending the rest of the night signing these books. This is it. It is the end of the night. I want to thank you all for being here on Facebook Live and on YouTube Live with me. I want to thank you all for submitting your questions. I am Matt Fraser, the psychic medium from the TV show Meet the Frasers. I am here with my fiance, Alexa Papadjotis. We just got engaged last night on Meet the Frasers on TV. Yeah. And this is my mom. I don't know if she's happy about that or not.
I gave you my lesson.
Okay, no, all right. True. This is my Italian mother, who you know from the TV show Meet the Frasers as well. Well, on E! Entertainment, if you missed an episode, you can go back and watch it. It's on demand and also on the E! App. It's also on Hulu. And this is my new book. It just came out today. It's called When Heaven Calls, Life Lessons from America's Top Psychic Medium. This is me. Look at, I'm all wrapped up in the telephone because this is me. I'm like the operator in heaven. So, as long as this link is up, you can get your signed copy of When Heaven Calls. I'm going to be signing them all night, and I'm going to be sending them over to you. So make sure that you go and you click the link up top to get your signed copy of When Heaven Calls, my brand new book. You do not have this book because it just came out today. It took a year to write. It's filled with all of my most powerful readings, life tools, ways that you can connect with your own psychic ability, and also how you can overcome challenges, struggles, and obstacles with divine guidance from heaven. It's the same tools and techniques that I've used that my mom taught me. And at the end of each chapter, there are tools for life to help guide you through every chapter and help you apply what you've learned to your own life so that you can live your most successful life. So I really hope this helps you. There's a little bit of psychic ability in all of us. Thank you for being here today. Thank you for watching my show. Thank you for being on YouTube. Thank you for being on Facebook. And if there's one thing that my mom always taught me, is treat everybody like family. So we love being on your TV screens on Monday night. We love that we get to welcome you in as our family. I love that you watch my videos, and I love that you're gonna be having your new copy of my book. Just make sure you get a signed copy while I'm here with you tonight. I wanna thank you all for being here. It was an honor and a privilege, and I love you all so much.
Bye.
See you later.
Bye now.